Alright, let's talk about the FNAF movie. Everyone's talking about Security Breach since the teaser trailer just came out, but I still haven't talked about the FNAF movie. In this video, I want to not as much talk about what we know already, I want to give my predictions for how the movie is going to go. But to do that, we do need to talk about just how it's been going so far, and what we do know so far. And honestly, it's not that much, so it shouldn't take long. Don't get me wrong, I think it's great that they're taking their time, just like Steel Wool seems to be with Security Breach. A lot of people have been complaining that it's taken so long, but as long as the end product is good, I honestly don't have much of a problem with that. I do still think they could have definitely finished it before now, if development was completely smooth, but whatever. The point is, I want to talk about my predictions for the movie, and to do that, we need to first talk about what we do know so far. So, first of all, it's going to be directed by Blumhouse. Don't know how you pronounce that, actually. Is it Blumhouse? Is it Blumhouse? I think it's Blumhouse. Whatever. And we don't know much other than that. Apparently, Scott said it's going to be based off of the first game, although I could see it having some elements from other games as well, or even the books. You don't know if it's going to have real animatronics or CGI. I hope we get real animatronics because we've seen some really cool ones online before, but we just don't really know. And that's pretty much it. I'm assuming we're probably going to see the MCI, the Missing Children's Incident. And other than that, I'm pretty sure it's just going to be a normal FNAF experience. I'm hoping it's not too similar to the Silver Eyes, you know, where some people just kind of get lost in a Freddy's restaurant and have to face off against the animatronics at night there. But I also don't want it to just be a security guard. What I'm really hoping for, actually, personally, is a detective scenario. Something like with what we've been seeing, spoiler alert, in the Fazbear Frights books with Detective Larson. Where there's an outsider, a detective, trying to figure out what happened at Freddy's with no prior information and piece together the pieces of the puzzle. I think it would be really cool to see in, like, a detective-style story with horror elements. As for who we'll see in this movie, obviously the original four and stuff, but I do hope we get, like, a cameo from Springtrap teasing a future movie. Scott has said that he would like to make this a trilogy, which, given how long it's taking for them to make the first one, I'm assuming the other two would take quite a long time as well. But again, with Security Breach absolutely blowing up, I'm assuming this franchise is gonna last quite a while yet. So, these are the specifics of what I'd like to see, but ultimately, all Security Breach needs to be is a good movie for fans of the series with a bit of lore to chew on, because, you know, we all know how much we love that. We love more complicated stories, it can't just be something super straightforward. But also something that is inviting to newer fans, which, you know, when I put it like that, it sounds like a big task, but I do think that the team working on the movie can do it. And Scott is apparently working very closely with the movie, and so with the fact that it's taken this long, I think that they're really taking their time to make sure it turns out pretty good. So, you know, I am not concerned. I feel like this movie is in very safe hands. Now, Scott has stated that apparently there's going to be, if the movie goes well, two sequels to create a trilogy. As for what games these will be based off of, I'm really not sure. I feel like Springtrap would at some point make an appearance, or maybe that's just me saying that because he's one of my favorite characters. I don't know. But I would really hope so. And I have a feeling Sister Location could also show up in one of them. Honestly, I feel like it could work as a trilogy, but I do hope that it doesn't stick too closely to the games and branches out and kind of creates its own unique story, you know? Which I'm sure it will do. I have no doubt that this movie is going to, it's not going to be like formulaic, you know? It's not going to be just a night guard in an office like the original game. It's going to branch out and try to create its own identity. If not, that would probably be bad. But as I was saying, in the end, all this movie really needs to be is something that's accessible to new fans and old fans alike, and just, you know, a good film. And from there, we can kind of, you know, figure out what's going to happen later on, like sequels and such. And so for now, I think that you know, obviously we don't know much about how the movie's going so far. Obviously we don't have much news at the moment. But I as the director of Blumhouse himself said, Jason Blum, it's moving rapidly forward. So I feel like we could see this movie sometime in the next 2 years, which, I mean, at this point, that's kind of a long time considering how we've already been waiting since 2015, but this movie's seen a lot of setbacks, and, I don't know, it's been in kind of development hell for a while, but I think we are finally on track to seeing this movie soon. Or that's just what Jason wants us to think. I have no idea. But regardless, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure to, you know, subscribe, because there is more content coming soon. I know every YouTuber says this, but I'm one you can trust, and I'm also better than, you know, most other YouTubers, so you can probably do that. Also, if you like this video, it is statistically almost guaranteed to be shown to more people. So, if you'd like others to see this movie and, you know my thoughts on the matter, then go ahead and do that as well. I'd really appreciate it. And in the meantime, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Buh-bye.